Hello everybody, it's Cape Rugby TV, Wednesday night, as you know, and we talk about the ins and outs of the world of Western Province. Club rugby, of course, over the last few weeks, it's been sevens, and it culminated this weekend at Goodwood, where it was the Blitzbokke and Marties and the Cape Rugby All-Stars side, as well as the Western Province Rugby Sevens side. We'll talk about more about that in a second or so. Let me introduce my panel tonight, Morgan Newman. Hello, Morgan.
How's it, Japs? How's it going?
Not too bad. I'm relying on you guys to fill me in tonight. Unfortunately, I could not, of all occasions, make it to the Sevens on Saturday.
There's not very many that you've missed, eh? For as long as I've known Cape Rugby to be around, yep. I think this may be the second, time that you've missed an event.
Yeah, there was the one time that you had to jump in, I think, at Philippi.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. It's probably that time and this weekend.
Yeah.
And the show, how many episodes, and you've never missed one, or have you?
Yeah, you've done one.
I've done one, actually. You haven't missed me very many.
Yeah, no, so that's 6 years. 6 years now, constantly.
Six years, 30 episodes, what's that? Yeah,
52 episodes.
Really?
Because we go right through the year, 52 episodes.
Fair enough. Very cheap.
I know.
I've done your fair share of time, man. Yeah. Put that in hours, you should be a pro now.
I'm working on my presentation skills. Also with me on the show, folks, Bobby Joubert. Hello, Bobs.
Hi, Jabs. Thanks for having me.
Having you back, yeah, I know. Well, we're definitely relying on you to tell us about the Sevens. You're, of course, the assistant coach at Western Province Rugby Sevens side. So you know what the quality, the standard. You'll be able to give us your professional opinion. You know, I'll rely on the professional opinion when it comes to you, and I'll ask when it comes to entertainment stuff, I'll ask Morgan Newman.
Spot on.
All right, folks, as you know, Hisense has, of course, come on board with Cape Rugby TV as the official technical partner. We thank them for that. And over the last few weeks, Score Energy Drinks has been on board with West Brom's Rugby Sevens, and we're very happy to have Score on board with Cape Rugby TV as well. And don't forget, Factory Shops SA mobile app. Download that app, that Factory Shops SA mobile app, and you'll find a factory shop near you. We'll talk more about that during the course of the show. Some interesting photographs came in from the fans, and we've got some great competitions lined up for you, so do not go anywhere. We'll also talk to you about the rest of the shows during the course of the year. Let's take a look now at our very first game from Saturday, where we were privileged enough to have the Blitzbokke and the Western Province Rugby Sevens, as well as the All-Star sides and Marties out there. We'll take a look now at the Dream Team B up against the Blitzbokke. Folks, there you can already see the quality of the Blitzbox. They won their 33-0 against Dream Team B. Belhar's Joel Boyson and Falsterbay's Dani Roux, of course, in the South African team. And the Dream Team B is coached by local boy Clement Trott. So good to have. Bobby, let's take it to you now. I mean, 33-0 in the world of sevens, that's not a massive margin and can be closed at any time. But just watching from that little clip there, you can see the quality of the guys.
Yeah, you must remember these guys got together on Saturday where we got the teams together and they didn't train. They had one training maybe. So good quality, yeah, I'm happy.
So the box, they haven't had a chance to get together?
No, I'm talking about the Dream
Team. Oh, the Dream Team, okay.
Obviously,
yeah.
They were chosen last week with the final day of the Club Sevens.
Morgs, your feeling?
No, I'll tell you what, I mean, for the Dream Team B2, you know, it's score can get big in sevens.
Yeah.
And to keep the box, too, I see some big names there. But World Sevens Player of the Year, Sabelis and Atla playing there against our Dream Team B. 33-0, I'll take that. I think I'll take that, actually.
It's interesting. When we were watching the clip, though, it looked like a couple of there were nearly a couple of chances, scoring opportunities for our Dream Team.
Yeah, 100%. We always know that the Springboks, throughout the years, have always been defensively a massively strong side.
Yeah. You
know, I think that they've based their game around, I think from Paul True days, and Neil Powell's adopted the same attitude. You know, defensively, they've got a good, massive rush defense, and they really do defend well. So, you know, the fact that they've just come together that morning, probably, and throwing the ball around, you know, they got close, and I think that's something they can take their hats off to. But to keep the Blitzbox down to 33 points, I think is pretty impressive, because as much as sevens is an attacking game, it also, if you need to be defensively sound, and if you just met the guy for the first time, or the first time you're playing with him, like we've spoken about, you know, week in and week out, you need to feel the guys around you, and these guys have never played together, and so I think, you know, yes, the 33 may seem big. But reality is, in a sevens game, the scores can get big very, very quickly.
Well, especially if you're a team that haven't played together, and you're coming up against the Springboks. I mean, you're expecting a massive margin. So clearly something did come through.
Yeah, I know. I mean, heaps of talent. Just from the highlights package, there's heaps of talent in both sides. And,
all right.
I think they're keeping the eye on the players.
All right, folks, let's check out one of the other star matches there now. It was Western Province A side up against Marty's. Let's see what happened. Some good result there. Western Province beating Marty's 28 points to 7. That's as it should be. I mean, it makes sense. But Marty's, of course, a well-coached outfit. Bobby, would you have expected Marty's to do better there, considering that they're almost semi-professional as a seven structure?
Yeah, Ian is doing very good work there at Marty's. But I think we also, as Western Province, Ian McLachlan.
Otherwise known
McGee,
as
Miyagi.
Miyagi. Yeah, Miyagi. I don't know. Where does this Miyagi thing come from anyway? Sorry. Bobby, I interrupted
That's
you.
Bloemfontein.
Is it a Bloemfontein thing?
Yeah.
Shame.
Our Western Province team is also a set unit. We've been playing the whole year with maybe three or four guys coming in as newcomers. So two well-oiled teams taking the stage there.
You got Brandon Collins there now. He's a star performer. How's he doing?
He actually had a good day. With Joel Boyson getting drafted up to the box, we needed some speed. And Ricky and I thought that this guy had potential, and we gave him a go. You know, there were many guys that we could have chosen, and I think he got the slot for the day.
All right. Western Province B side up against the Dream Team B side. Folks, if you've just tuned in, you're probably wondering what are we talking about in terms of the B sides and the A sides and all so forth. Well, over the last 6-7 weeks, we've had the Western Province Rugby Sevens tournament happening over at Goodwood Rugby Football Club. It's kindly sponsored, of course, by Score Energy Drinks. And from the culmination of the six tournaments, we managed to select two dream teams, an A side and well, we wouldn't really say an A side and a B side, but two dream teams put together to take on the Springbok Sevens, the Blitzbox, who came out to Goodwood over the weekend. So if you're just tuning in now, you've got a little bit of catch up to do, because there are Western Province A and B sides from proper Western Province teams was also there. So let's catch up now with the Western Province B side up against the B side in the Dream Team side. The B side from Western Province up against the Dream Team B side. Western Province, of course, winning there 12 points to 10. That's a little bit closer, Bobby. How do you explain such a close margin?
Well, good matchup. I think the Western Province Invitational team also got together in the week, coached by Labib Levy. So they actually were very competitive.
You know, when Labib is involved in something, you know that there's a bit of danger, because he's going to come up with some sort of gedachte.
Yeah, he doesn't need training sessions for his team to do well.
Morgs, but the last few weeks, it would have helped the guys run, stay fit, have their movements, and but like you say, not necessarily gelling as a team yet. And I'm sure that after we keep watching the clips, we're going to see by the second game, the third game, that we might start seeing them. I'm quite excited to see what's going to happen, because I know what had happened with the Cape Rugby side. The first game you lost, the second game it came even, the third game you guys were flying.
Yeah, without a doubt, you know. So it's the nice thing about an environment like that is they're not being coached into a box. So they're actually there to just express the talent that they've got. You know, so often, yes, Sevens is a very much a structured game. You need to train together and so forth. But in an environment, just purely this environment, they've literally been given the stage to perform.
Yeah.
And sometimes the rough diamonds emerge in an environment like that, you know. So often today we talk about coaching these players and, you know, you need to be structured, you need to do this, and you need to do that, and in this situation you do this, and when you're in that situation you do that. Meanwhile, sometimes some of these players need to be just given the ball and say, make magic.
Play.
And that's where you'll see the talent that really exists in the club rugby setup. That's in an environment like that, you see it, because then they haven't been coached yet.
But isn't that kind of like, I mean, I don't want to move away from the Sevens topic now, but isn't that one of those things that we're looking for? Western Province Rugby is known for running rugby, and we see it here on the TV screen now, and you know, over the years gone by, we know Western Province rugby has always been known to play with flair. All the play. I mean, you played for Province for many years yourself, as yourself did, Bobby. So the question here is, where are we losing this? Why are we not playing with running rugby on a national level or expressing ourselves? Or do we start losing it the higher up that you go? Or is it a question of just simply that sevens is supposed to be entertainment rugby?
Yes, so this is you're opening a can of worms here for me personally, because I've got quite...
okay, well, just take one worm out. I don't want you to open the whole can.
No, but look, I mean, the reality is our coaches today don't have the skills to coach the talent that we have. And it's, you know, so when you don't have the skills to coach the talent we have, what we resort back to strict structured play, because in that box you can only go so far. Whereas if we can find the coaches to coach the talent that we have, put these players in positions to actually make magic.
Isn't it surely a question of the coaches must give the players opportunity? Because we look at these guys playing sevens here. If the coaches that you're talking about don't actually take those players and put them on a field, they're never going to have the players to coach. So that's got to be the first part. You've got to take these guys and give them an opportunity.
Well, 100%, you know, and the reverse of it is structure is safe. You know?
What do you mean? What do you, explain that to me.
When you play structured rugby, safe. Yeah, it's safe. You know what they're going to do.
Yeah.
You know? And when your salary is dependent on your team's performance, you'll probably also be safe.
Well, that could be also then that I might be making the mistake of looking at sevens rugby and going, oh, wow, look at the talent. And then saying, well, why aren't we doing this in 15s? And that's not necessarily fair, because maybe I'm not comparing apples with apples.
No, well, where we're lacking, and maybe Bobby's probably better equipped to answer the question than me, but where I think we're lacking is we're not creating the space on the rugby field for the players to express themselves. Going, you see a player, you run straight at him, pick him up, and try and physically dominate him. Next guy comes around the corner, physically dominate
him. Run straight at
him. We don't create space, so we don't maybe play into the one corner, so there'd be two good passes with players that have skill, put it into space, and then it's for the player one-on-one to make magic, to bring out that talent.
All right, so Bobby, you are more equipped to answer this question, so.
Well, I think.
So let's ask you.
I think talking about attacking players, this was a very good weekend to show it, because it was 70 odd club players given an opportunity to create space, no training, no boxes, no structures. So it was raw talent just hitting the field and then playing into space. And you can see the quality out there. Obviously, they'll lack in sevens a bit of defensive structures, because that's where you see you didn't train much. But the attack was brilliant.
All right. Okay, folks, we're going to take an ad break. When we come back, we'll keep asking a couple of interesting questions. 70-odd players. I love that number. 70-odd players having a go on the park. And, well, if you see them running like that, I'll tell you something. There is a team or two around the world that I would probably have put some of those players into right now. But we'll see you after the break. Well, it's been an incredible couple of weeks of Sevens Rugby at Goodwood Rugby Football Club with the Western Province Rugby Sevens, proudly, of course, sponsored by Score Energy Drinks. And we had some real talent out there and getting opportunity to meet some of the other players. Now, last year, one of the fantastic elements of the Sevens was the fact that the guys managed to play outside the league. So clubs from Super League B played against Super League A and Super League C, managed to play against Super League B. So it was a real intermingle. And this year, even more special, that clubs from all the different leagues for the first 6 weeks managed to play against each other. And then after that, managed to play against the Western Province side and then against the Blitz Box. But anyway, let's take a look now at one of our next matches. It was the Dream Team selected from the Sevens, the A side, up against Marty's. there for the Dream Team, 17-12 over Marty's. All right, that's a little bit more of a level playing field, Morgs. Some of the Marty's guys, I think, probably even in the Dream Team side. But you can see there, 17-12, a little bit more equal.
Yeah, that's the kind of, you know, when two, you know, very good sides collide, then often that's the margin you see, you know, 5-point margin, one try here and there. And, yeah, I mean, look, again, just pure quality, you know.
But also, that some of those guys that were playing the Dream Team would have been playing in the same team the week before, for example, if you came playing for Marty's. Yeah. Or, I mean, did you guys select any Marty's players for? Okay, so the Marty's guys, were they completely excluded because they would be playing?
Only because they played as a club team.
Okay.
In the event,
yeah. And because they were going to play the next week, yeah, as a full, sure, outfit. All right, okay. So, and I suppose the same would apply for Western. So nobody played against each other that played together the week before?
No, all the Western Province guys played for their clubs.
Right, okay.
So we just drafted them back into the squad again. But the Marty's we kept as a team just to be competitive, yeah, in this Saturday.
I think it's quite funky, actually, Morgs.
I think it's super cool. I mean, I just, yeah, like we were talking off air. I love sevens and I love 15s. Don't get me wrong. I love rugby in general. But the point is, I think you might get a lot of guys starting to see that sevens is more appealing to them than 15s. I mean, if a league like this exists, you know, I'm talking the Score 7 series now.
Yeah.
If a league like that exists, you may get guys that say, right, I'm not going to play 15s, and come, they stay fit or do their thing, and come the end of the year, for however long the Score 7 series is, they come and they play sevens, and you see amazing talent come to the fore, you know? Because reality is, there are a lot of sevens guys, like we spoke about, that can't play, that won't necessarily make a first 15 side, but can make a first sevens side for their club, closed eyes.
Yeah.
So it's going to be a big balancing act. I think a lot of clubs are going to have to start to play.
Well, I think it's very exciting if you consider the fact that these guys were given jerseys this year. You know, you went and did the Impy Challenge over the weekend, which was quite a social occasion. And for the last 6 weeks, we've seen a social occasion. Camping chairs were out, the gazebos
But that's what I'm saying. Yeah. I mean, all the clubs, one venue. I mean, that kind of appeals to me. Like, even if I played 15s, yeah, imagine we could make a day where we all go to play at the same venue. Or no, I know that's not possible. But if 10 clubs played 5 games all at the same venue, imagine it's a social. It becomes a massive social occasion.
There's no problem
weekly
with that. I mean, you just played 36 teams on one venue, yeah, so it's easy to do.
So yeah, you know what I mean. Sevens is becoming more and more appealing.
I'm loving it. It gives us a, and I'm loving the fact that we've been giving some of the coaches and managers also an opportunity to be involved in the structures. Actually, Stoffels, for example, was coaching the Dream side there, and those are the kind of things that we want to see. Put in so much hard work at Belleville during the 15-man season, and now he's coaching the Dream side. So that's really good. And, of course, that team side also included the player of the season, Carlton Goodman. Right, folks, if you want to win yourself a case of Score Energy Drinks, all right, Score is, of course, the energy drink sponsor that's come on board with the Western Province Rugby Sevens as the official Sevens partner for this year. You can tell us who is the official sponsor of the All-Star Sevens tournament. All you need to do is go to our Facebook page and upload your photograph. Congratulations to last week's winner, Nabila Kayser. Nabila posted this fantastic picture there of a Score energy drink and a set of rugby boots. So great picture. So fantastic stuff, Nabila. One of the guys from Cape Rugby TV or one of the girls will get a hold of you shortly and make sure that you have got your case of Score energy drinks ready for a collection. Folks, we asked you, of course, to keep sending in those social media photographs, and it's fantastic to see them. Our first picture here, of course, came in fact, from at Score Energy Drink. These are the Blitzbox. 35-7 win against the Western Province A side, and the tagline there, what's Sevens is all about. The Blitzbox in action there, and nice photographs of the boys and sitting there with the Western Province side. And then there was Siabela Sanatla in action on the charge. Alice Michaels from Western Province, at least from Western Province Club Rugby, took this picture. Alice Michaels, the Blitzbox, 29-5 against the Dream Team. Fantastic picture, Alice. Siabela Sanatla taking a great little step there, as we know how dangerous he can be. Giving it horns, shared by at Martin Mulder, 25, at least 12-10 in the Western Province against the Dream side. And yeah, so fantastic stuff there. Nice pictures. From all of you sending those pictures in, and Keep sending those pictures in. Put yourself in the mix to win a couple of prizes courtesy of Score and Easy Drinks. Folks, we will be back after the break and up for more games. And of course, the next game we'll be looking at will again be the Blitzbox, this time up against Western Province B. Back in a sec. Welcome back, folks. Yes, it is, of course, Cape Rugby TV. And for those of you that wondered what's happening with Cape Rugby TV after the league is finished, well, we keep going. We've got a good few weeks to go. But, you know, for those of you that don't know, right now there are many teams out there, there are clubs out there that are still doing award ceremonies. Some clubs have already started with pre-season for next year. Many teams are busy working on analysis, conditioning. It's all started. So, folks, we've got absolutely more than enough content. Plus, we'll be taking a look at some of the physical aspects coming up in terms of coaching and technical skills. We'll take a look at that. We might even take a look at some of the legends of Western Province, or I'm not going to use that word anymore, legends, more interesting people in Western Province rugby. That'll be the catchphrase. Interesting people in the history of Western Province rugby. We'll take a look at that. But we'll also be streaming some of our shows where we want you to join on the stream. So very important that you pay attention to our Facebook and Twitter handles when we do the live streaming, where our guests will be on the panel and we'll be taking your questions via social media and via the chat room that we'll engage with you on social media. And you can talk to us and we'll put this time the questions to the panel. It'll be an open discussion and we'll do a couple of those shows pre-recorded and then play it out. And if you're watching the show, then you can still see what all those comments were that were coming in on the live stream, and that'll come up over the next couple of weeks. So make sure that you pay attention to Facebook, because you might have to watch the show live at your office somewhere, or over lunchtime, or who knows. Well, we'll put it out there. Let's check out our next game now. It's with Blitzbox up against the Western Brahmins B side. Box, Western Province B beating the Western Province B side there, 49 points to nil. Western Province under 19 stars Zane Davids included now in the South African team, and Western Province B would go on to finish fourth overall. Look out for a huge hit there that you might have seen from Joel Boyson. Bobby, excuse me, just let's go there. Western Province under 19 stars Zane Davids included in the South African side.
Well, not surprised at all. He had a very good tournament at the Interprovincials in Nelspruit, playing for the Griffins team, who did very well at the tournament. So, yeah, he was superb.
All right, how does this selection process work? Can you fill us in? Do you know? Is it just a question of the scouts are watching at Western Province? Or I suppose the Springbok selectors are there?
They are all there at the Interprovincials in Nelspruit.
Yeah.
So, guys performing, they draft up. So, Jason Creel was drafted up into the setup, as well as Zane.
All right, so is the entire Blitzbok side now Western Province?
Not yet.
Not yet. Yeah. Just almost.
Let's hope the coaches go too.
You see, Morgs, if you were playing on Saturday and you didn't go to the MP challenge, then you might even have been selected to play for the Springbok Sevens.
James, yeah, it's I can dream, man. Eh? Nothing wrong with dreaming.
But didn't you play for the Springbok Sevens?
I was involved in the setup, but I didn't play for them. No.
I thought you've done this. I mean, because you've done just about every other team.
Yeah, I've done my rounds. Yeah, no, that's for sure.
Between you and Paul Delport and Ishmael Dolly, you guys have had a few international struck.
Yeah, I'm still waiting for our reunion show. Eh? Never doesn't seem to happen.
Keeps the bond alive.
Keeps looks so busy now. Eh?
Yeah, and Paul Delport is extremely busy. I mean, we hardly talk to him anymore.
Yeah, he's actually he's preparing at the moment because he's going away this. I think it's on Friday. Friday or Sunday he leaves for Dubai. He heads over to Dubai. I think the seventh circuit kicks off, and then he's taking the academy side there, and they're playing in another tournament also in Dubai. So he travels with the box. So busy man, busy man. I did catch up with him on the weekend.
Well, if we can't get him on the show because he's too busy, and Paulie, hopefully you're watching right now, then we have to catch up with him on the side of the field.
Firstly, I think it's testament to our system. That's Abelo and Kwaka and Sticky and the guys that have been in our system for a while and have played on the circuit are willing to come and play in the academy tournaments. Because I think it's the easiest way for our academy guys to learn. It's playing with people that know how to play the game. Obviously, even Mario Schumann's a fantastic coach, and we try and help the guys and try and get them into the system as quickly as possible. But the quickest way that the guys learn is to play and to play with experienced players. So much talent, not just in the Western Cape, but in South Africa, and that's what we'd like to do at the academy, to bring the talented guys in, just to show them our setup. I think a lot of the guys just for them to see how we do things, just in terms of professionalism, in terms of maybe changing the way they train, just realizing what they need to work on in terms of their individual skills development will be fantastic. And for us at the Springbok Sevens system, you know, with Neil and the guys up there, and with us in the academy, we just want to grow the game. Again, I think it's absolutely wonderful. I think the onus is being put on Sevens and the development of Sevens, and there's a hell of a lot of talent here. And again, for the supporters to come out on a windy Saturday after a long rugby season, it's just testament to the rugby being played here. And I think all the teams have done very, very well. They all play a different brand of rugby, and it's exciting, and all the guys are out there expressing themselves. So for us, we're obviously using it as preparation pre-Dubai. But for the guys here, it's a great way for them to express themselves and just, I think, also get into pre-season a little bit fitter.
All right there, Paul Delport, of course, he's been on Cape Rugby TV many, many, many times. Morgs, I believe that in his off time, playing a little bit of golf?
Yes, chaps. You use the word golf, you'd rather use it more loose than that. Paulie's golf is...
Is he
I shouldn't be laughing at
him. Okay, no, we won't laugh at it.
But golf is not one of his strengths. He's a better rugby player, we put it that way.
Probably
or
still.
Or coach, or whatever.
Probably still, all right. Okay, Paul Delport. Paulie, if you're watching there, seriously, don't worry about the handicap. We know, maybe in golf sometimes it can
Cape Rugby TV Golf Day.
Cape Rugby TV Golf Day. Yes, Cape Rugby Day.
You can bring all the old dogs. Come on, man.
Bobby,
we need to put content together.
Yeah?
Yeah.
This idea coming up.
Each club can have their own four ball. I mean, it works like a dream.
Bobby?
All great ideas. I think Morgs can organize it.
Yeah, Morgs.
We've got enough of a team to organize it. I just want to play. Because I got the Cape Rugby TV Sevens team, which we still need to find a place for.
Yes.
Now we need the Cape Rugby TV four ball in the Cape Rugby TV Golf Day. It works like a dream.
Great. Got three guys already.
The brand is traveling.
The brand is traveling. Yes, a Cape Rugby TV Golf Day. And I suppose now it's that time of the year where we could have one. We just got to get a golf club to sponsor it and a couple of other sponsors to sponsor a few wet holes and a couple of gazebos and some strapping. We, of course, need lots and lots of strapping.
Speak for yourself, Speak for yourself, because I know you strap.
I'm one of the few guys.
You strap as much as even Smith stretches for rugby and JP stretches for a golf. For a round of golf. I swear, I kid you not.
Well, I think I've got about as many injuries as even Smith. Well, maybe not at the moment, but I think my head is still okay. Western Roman's A side, we're up against the Dream Team A side. We'll be right back. right, folks. Yes, fantastic result there. It was, of course, the Western Brom's A side up against the Dream side, 1917, or at least 1907. Western Brom's would go on, of course, into the finals against the Blitzbox, and the Dream Team A side finishing third overall. Right, as we said, folks, we keep getting in some fantastic photographs. Let's take a look at some of the more of the pictures that came in over the weekend. This Joel Boyson, Joel shared this picture here. Blitzbox get a club rugby injection. It was, of course, shared by at Joel Boyson, and the Blitzbox making it 4 from 4. And fantastic picture in here from Brackenfell Rugby Football Club. Bracke in full support for the score. All Stars, the score All Stars Sevens Rocks Goodwood. Nice picture. All right, folks, so when we come back after the break, it's time for us to look at the Blitzbox up against the Dream Team A side. Donnie Roo, of course, starring for the Blitzbox, and look out for a sensational long range try from Siabela Sanatla. That after the break. Welcome back, folks. Yes, we're going to get straight into it so we can get as much content in as possible. Still got some interviews from Mr. Danny Jones, the general manager of Western Province Rugby, Joel Boyson, and of course the guys from Score Energy Drinks were talking to us as well. And Siabela Sanatla, but that comes up shortly. First, let's check out the Blitzbox up against the Dream Team A side. Game there, the Blitzbox up against the Dream Team A side. Folks, as I said, we're going to cut the conversation a little bit short at the moment. What a pleasure, though, to have the Springboks over at Goodwood. And you know, what I really love about the fact that the boys were there is that so seldom we see the international or the provincial players coming down to club rugby nowadays. So to see Siabela Sanatla there on the side of the field together with his Blitzbox compatriots, how fantastic was that? Well, we managed to speak to Siabela himself.
It's great, man. I think for me, it's nothing out of the ordinary because this is where I come from and this is the level that I've played at before. So for me, it's like, it's not actually going back to that level, but it's playing and trying to maintain the standard I play in. And I'm pretty grateful for the opportunity that I got to play in the academy side a little bit, to Mr. Jays a little bit there with the boys. Jamming, it's less pressure. We enjoy playing here. So pretty chuffed to have joined the squad here and given a chance to play this side. So playing amongst the people, we don't do that much. As tennis players, we only play once at home in a year. So as much as you can play at home, the more joy that you get from it, because you're playing amongst the people and people that admire and people that like and people that are shouting for you. You get encouraged to see how much hope you're expressing to the people outside you. So it's great. We get a lot of love from the people and they encourage us to do a little bit more. So we love playing at home, man. Whether it's club rugby, whether it's playing Curry Cup, whether it's playing sevens, whether it's anything. Playing at home is quite wonderful, and it's one thing that we truly enjoy. My advice would be to dream a little bigger. Normally, we think these things are far from us, but I come from the same level that they come from. I've played club rugby, I've played a little bit of club sevens, I've played at a very low level, and so sometimes we think we're small enough or we're not big enough for these opportunities. But truth is, if you're doing big enough and you follow your dreams, you will reach up one day. You must work pretty hard and you must have so much perseverance, you must be persistent in your effort and consistent in it, and I think the results will come a little bit at the end there for you. But one thing that I must say is dream. That's the most important thing.
Siyabela Sinatla, what a legend. And we really love the fact that he's able to get out there with the boys and speak to us at ground level. Morgs, we need more of this. If we had more of the our international superstars maybe coming down to club level, then it would be very good for our local people to feel connected to their national superstars.
Yeah, 100%. He's the ultimate role model, I think. You know, he was where he comes from. Last week, he was over somewhere in the world, in London, I think, receiving his World Player of the Year.
Oh, yeah.
And now he's at the... Done good at performing for his team.
Yeah.
I think we need more of that. Yeah, definitely. I think if Springboks did more of that, maybe we'd see some better results too.
Yeah, don't get me started on that. I don't like to comment on that. But if I had to give my opinion, I would say that if you want to play rugby for South Africa, then you should live in South Africa full time. But I don't really like to talk about it. So I won't give my opinion. Although my opinion is that if you want to have a successful team, you should be in the same country. But we'll leave it at that. All right, I see you. No one's making any comments on that one. All right. There was the Western Province Dream side. They were at least the Western Province A side this time, up against the Western Province B side. Folks, let's get straight into it. Without the sponsors, the Western Province Club Rugby Score Sevens competition would have been impossible to have at this level. And so fantastic to have our sponsors on board. And Score Energy Drinks has come on board. And we managed to speak to the brand manager from Score, Dean Tierbus.
It's really been fantastic for us. It's been a really exciting journey. Obviously, this is the first year of our real involvement with Western Province and Sevens Rugby. It's really, really been great, and nice to have the Blitzbocker here playing against our top club rugby guys in the Score Dream Team, and you know, providing them with a platform to maybe take the next step in the rugby world. Yeah, look, it's fantastic, and I must say congrats to all the club rugby teams. Their supporters came through and to watch excellent rugby week after week, and the weather's also been on our side. So really grateful to have all the supporters coming every week and showing the gees.
Well done, Dean. Nice to see you wearing your Score jersey there in full force and your Score cap. It's been fantastic having you and the guys from Score on board. So welcome to the world of Western Province Rugby. We hope that you have enjoyed it and that you will stay with us for many, many years to come. Folks, we're going to move straight along now, and it was the Blitzbox up against the Western Province A-side in the Cup final. Siyabulela was, of course, the star of the show, as we would expect. There, congratulations then to the Blitzbox, who of course win the tournament as one would expect, beating the West Roms A side in the Cup final. We managed to speak also now to Danny Jones, the general manager of Western Province Rugby, and Joel Boyson, who's made it into the Super Leagues. Let's speak to the guys.
I've been in the club sevens for the past 6 weeks, and getting the call up again to join the Blitzbox is a really good, great opportunity, and it's nice exposure for the guys in the club sevens to get the opportunity to play against the Blitzbox team. We can't say it's easy, but we have to give our all, seeing that we're on a high level and things like that. But there's really much great talent out there in the club rugby, and seeing that we're playing against Province again, there are really great talent in there.
I firstly need to thank Score and all the other sponsors from the union side for giving us an opportunity to have a 7 week of absolutely centralizing rugby. We're proud of all our clubs, all 36 who initially participated in the 6 week tournament, and then also all the players who rocked up today. We're proud of what they have achieved here today, as well as we want to thank the Blitzbocker for coming today. I think it's a tremendous opportunity for both club players and the Blitzbocker to have shared their skills. This interaction between the Blitzbocker and our club players does a lot for our club rugby. At least it gives the club players an opportunity to measure themselves and then use this measurement going forward to improve their game. So we are very, very proud of this Score Western Province Sevens tournament. And I want to thank the Goodwood Rugby Football Club for allowing us to use these facilities. And I also want to thank SA Rugby for bringing the Blitz Poker here. And then last but not least, I want to thank all the supporters who relentlessly rocked up here every weekend to support Club Rugby. We thank you for your wonderful participation, your wonderful support, and the fact that Club Rugby is in your hearts.
Right, folks, it's been an incredible show. It's been an incredible 6 weeks. We'll have a continuation of the show next week. And so stay tuned, because next week might very well be the interactive live stream session that we'll pre-record during the week. So if you want to be part of that, where possibly you'll be able to phone into the show, you'll be able to comment on Twitter, and you'll be able to comment on Facebook, and you'll be able to comment on the chat room. So you need to pay close attention to our Facebook feed. And if you want to be part of that, so if you perhaps have got Skype with a reasonable bandwidth and you want to come onto the show with us, then please send us a message on Facebook that you want to be part of the show on www.facebook.com/CapeRugbyTV. Morgan Newman, thanks very much for joining us. It's been a rare pleasure, and glad to see you haven't shaved your wannabe mo off.
Always good to be here, James. Thanks for having me. I've left mine to be fairly rough. As for yours over there, I don't know.
I don't know so much.
I'm still trying to work out what is going on there.
Well, it's my mode to support a bro.
Well, to all the viewers, if I did look shell-shocked on the show, it's because I'm trying to work out.
Don't worry, it'll be gone by the weekend. I think I said that last week as well, but it'll be gone. Anyway, folks, it's Movember in aid of supporting prostate cancer. Bobby, it's been great seeing you on the show, and we hope to have you on the show shortly again, and also join us on our live stream show.
Thanks, Japs. Been a pleasure.
Lekker. Right, folks, that's a wrap from us. I'm sure there's rugby action over the weekend somewhere, and wherever it is, we will find it. That's a wrap. We'll see you again next week, same time, same place. Have a fantastic rugby weekend. Bye-bye.